Hello and welcome to Pitt Beyond the Script alongside Pat Bosick, the former quarterback, who, of course, you can hear on the radio network. I'm Rob King of AT&T Sportsnet. Pat, a lot to get to with this game. The Panthers are bowl eligible. We'll talk about that. 6-3 now with the victory down at Georgia Tech. Always good to get an ACC win. And a lot of positives to talk about in this game. Let's start with Alex Kessman, because this is a guy who early on in the season wasn't what I think everybody expected, wasn't what he expected. And now all of a sudden he's becoming a rock steady guy with a great leg who can make clutch kicks.
He certainly has. And I think you have to, you know, his mental strength is probably what I would speak to first. Obviously going through the tough start to the year, it's not easy for anybody. And kicker, you get 1, 2, maybe 3 opportunities a game. So you better have a short memory from week to week. He's proven that. I don't know what he did technically, but he looks comfortable out there. Drilled a 49-yarder to start the fourth quarter. That was pivotal. They were up 7 at the time. Pick go from a 1 to a 2-score game. And he's just been consistent, really, the last 4 or 5 weeks.
Vincent Davis in the Wildcat.
Finds a crack. Dodges a man at the 45. Foot race to the 50, to the 45, the 30. He's to the 25, the 20. 15, 10. Touchdown, Vincent Davis. Longest run of the year. This one goes 61 yards for the Panther touchdown.
Nice to see the big play happen in this game too. Vincent Davis comes up with a big 61-yard run.
Another one that came out of a stoppage, you know, first play from scrimmage, you know, on the Wildcat set, which they were running with Todd Sibley against Miami. Sibley obviously out, so Vincent Davis in there with the club on his arm, took it 61, and that was their longest touchdown run of the year by a long shot. Those big plays, I think when you look at trying to prescribe what the remedy is for some of the struggles offensively in the second half, they're missing big plays, and that was certainly a huge one.
Shotgun snap. Throwing for the near sideline, and that is pulled in at the pylon. A touchdown, Shockey Jacques-Louis. Pick it, 22 yards to Shockey Jacques.
Tell me what you saw from the quarterback's perspective on the pass hookup with the touchdown pass in the game.
Yeah, you know, Shockey Jacques-Louis is a guy that, I mean, when you look at the pass distribution, obviously Kenny Pickett's completing almost 24.5 passes per game. Taysier Mack and Maurice French certainly are the majority of those. But having Shockey step into a more prominent role, he's going to elicit one-on-one coverage because they're going to try to help out with those crossing routes and those patterns to Maurice. But when you got Shockey winning a one-on-one coverage on a back shoulder fade to score a touchdown, that makes defensive coordinators cringe because now, hey, we got to worry about him too. That's really important to see, and Kenny Pickett's confidence in him is probably more important than anything. He went to him in a one-on-one situation, and the young man pulled through for him.
Snap. Graham swallowed up by the rush. He's going to be hit, and he's going to be sacked at the 15-yard line. Great job by John Morgan from his defensive end spot.
We have to concentrate again on the defense because another spectacular, stifling effort from the Pitt D.
It was. I mean, the sack numbers aren't. They're still leading the country with 40, but only 2 sacks. They don't speak to the pressure they're getting. It's psychological at this point for the opposition. They're expecting to get blitz. They're expecting to get pressure. Quarterbacks are acting that way. So they're getting rid of the ball quick. They're trying to scramble quickly. It's allowing the coverage on the back end to play tighter because they know the ball's coming out because these teams are planning to get hit. They're planning for the pressure to get home. So I really think they're doing a great job with pressure. And the linebacking core probably goes unseen. Probably the biggest play of the year was that fumble on the goal line caused by Kylan Johnson, then returned by Cam Bright. I mean, you talk about just a knockout punch. This was a huge hit, probably the play of the year by Kylan Johnson, and then saw Cam Bright's speed. He looked like he might be able to play running back.
Yeah, and then one other guy that I would love to mention because I just think he's had a spectacular season is Paris Ford.
He's a ball hawk. His instincts are tremendous. He's been just a lockdown tackler. He finds a way to get in the area where the ball is. As detailed and technical as you want guys to be, what coaches can't teach is a guy just having an instinct and a nose for the ball. And it might drive Corey Sanders, the safety coach, crazy at times because he's not doing exactly what he's supposed to do per the coverage. But 9 times out of 10, he is directly where that football is.
Well, the other thing I think that's happening by winning games like this, the Panthers have now won 5 of their last 6 games. And look, you could say they should have blown teams out, but there's a handful of games in there they could have been on the losing end of as well. Is there something to a team building character and a winning belief saying, hey, listen, we've been in a lot of close games. We expect to win these games. I always feel like a team like that, that's good for a win or two before you even begin the season.
It is. I mean, you even go back to the Miami game, Rob. I mean, you know, obviously they're in a close game. They kick a field goal to go up 12-10. They have every belief they're going to win that football game. Even when they get the ball left down 16-12 with 58 some odd seconds left to go, they got a chance to make plays on that drive. I think this team has belief. If someone asked me last week, watching practice, are they really down? No, they're not, because they believe they're going to run the table. And that's what's good about the locker room and the culture right now, is they believe. They believe in their coaches, they believe in themselves. And that certainly portends well for the remainder of this year.
Before I let you go, Kylan Johnson is going to be joining us next segment. What can you talk about the Florida transfer, the grad transfer, who's really put up great numbers for the Panthers?
Well, first of all, I mean, he's a great kid. I mean, he's been a leader since he arrived on campus. He's got a personality that's very, it's calming for the guys around him. He's a veteran linebacker that's been in SEC battles. You can't put a price tag on that. That's a big brand of football down there. It's kind of hard to believe watching him that he wasn't more of a mainstay for the Gators. I'm sure there's a number of reasons for that. He's fast, he hits, he's excellent in coverage. He has been as impactful a transfer as I think this program has had in a long, long time. There's been good ones. Taysier Max, another one. But I really believe he is playing as good a football on this defense as maybe everybody, but potentially Paris Ford and Patrick Jones, and that's saying something.
Looking forward to talking to Kylan Johnson. That's coming up next. Pat, thanks very much for the time. Always appreciate it. All right, stick around. We have Kylan Johnson joining us when we return on Pitt Beyond the Script.
Oh, dude.